Hello students, welcome to the second part of optics and optical instrument. Here we discuss about characteristic of an image formed by a plane mirror, the minimum height of the mirror so a person can able to see his full image. If we rotate the plane mirror at an angle theta, then the reflected ray will be rotated by 2 theta. Characteristic of an image formed by a plane mirror. So let's take a mirror. Take that M1, M2, an object. Place certain distance from a plane mirror. Here that incident ray falls on the mirror at point X and Y. Take as AX and BY are the two incident ray. After reflection, that reflected ray diverges. That XC and YD, the two reflected ray diverges, but appears to comes behind the mirror. This is produced behind the mirror as that of the object is in front of the mirror. That means the distance of the object from the mirror. What is the distance of the object from the mirror? That is equal to the distance of image from the mirror. So the distance of object from the mirror take as object distance, and the distance of image from the mirror take as image distance. So object distance is equals to image distance. As that image is produced behind the mirror, image is virtual and erect. Also, image is upright. Also, what happened? The size of the object is equal to the size of the image. That means here magnification 1. That magnification, that formula is the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object. That is equal to 1 because that size of the image is equal to size of the object. And image is laterally inverted. That means left, right, reversed happen. This all about characteristic of image formed by a plane mirror. Now let's focus on figure 1. What is the minimum height of plane mirror so a person can able to see his full image? That is, the minimum height of a plane mirror should be half of the size of the person, so the person can able to see his full image. How it possible? Let's derive it. Here we consider that mirror M1, M2, and the person take as AB, your head and feet, and the person's eye take as E. The two incident ray take as the two incident ray comes from head and feet of the person and hit the mirror surface. The two incident ray A M1, B M2. After reflection, the two reflected ray M1E, M2E, the two reflected ray converge and meet at person's eye. But the two reflected ray appears to be comes behind the mirror, so that the image is produced behind the mirror, and here that image is virtual image. Okay, the two reflected ray meet at person's eye, and person can able to see his image behind the mirror. Okay, now what happened here? At the point of incident, we know that angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. At the two point of incident, if we draw normal, and here angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection, so this value is equal to this value. AO is equal to EO. Like at the second point of incidence, this angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection, so that PB is equal to PE. If we draw perpendicular at the point E to the mirror, that is the imaginary line EO, draw perpendicular EO, then what happen? EO is equal to MQ, and EP is equal to M2Q. Take as M1Q equals to X and M2Q equals to Y. So what is the height of the mirror? That is M1, M2 equals to X plus Y. Okay, height of the mirror that is M1, M2 equals to X plus Y. Then here height of the person, that is AB. So AB equals to AE plus EB.
option AB. AB equals to AE plus EB. So what is AE? AE equals to AO plus EO. AO plus EO, or AO is equals to EO, so AE equals to 2 times of EO. Okay, so put that first one, AO equals to AE equals to AO plus EO, and EB equals to EP plus EB. Next, as AO is equals to EO, so AO plus EO, that is 2 times of EO, and EP plus EB, that is 2 times of EP, where 2 is the common factor. Then EO, that EO is equals to M1Q, and EP is equals to M2Q. Put the value, M1Q, that is X, M2Q, that is Y. So 2 times of X plus Y. So what is X plus Y? That is the height of the mirror. So AB equals to 2 times of M1, M2, or we written as M1, M2 is equals to half of AB. That means the height of the mirror is equals to half of the height of the person. So the person can able to see his full image in that plane mirror. Here another way to deduce the height of the mirror is equals to height of is equals to half of the height of the person. So the person can able to see his own image in the plane mirror. So here what happened? The same procedure happened. A M1, B M2 are the two incident ray strike the surface of the plane mirror and reflection occur. Here M1E, M2E are the two reflected ray meet at point E and the person's eye, so that the person able to see his own image. The two reflected ray appears to comes behind the mirror and image is produced behind the mirror, that is the visual image is produced. Here that object distance is equals to image distance. Take as that object distance X, that means the distance of object from mirror take as X. So same here, the distance of image from mirror, that is also X. Now here if we draw a perpendicular from point E to mirror and to the image, that is the imaginary line. Okay, now here what happened? M1E, M2, one triangle, A1E, A prime, E, B prime, that is the second triangle. These two triangle equivalent to each other. Take as triangle M1E, M2 and triangle A prime, E, B prime. So here what happened? M1, M2 by A prime B prime is equals to E Q by E Q prime. E Q by E Q prime. Okay, so what is E Q? E Q equals to X. What is E Q prime? That is equals to 2X. Then here M1 M2 by A prime B prime. XX get cancelled. So M1 M2 is equals to half of A prime B prime. As a, that height of the image is equals to height of the object. So that M1 M2 is equals to half of AB. That means the mirror height is equals to half of the height of the object.
Now go to figure 2. What is the minimum height of a plane mirror? So an observer at the center of the room can able to see full image of the wall behind him. Here the size of the plane mirror is 1/3 of the size of the wall. How it possible? Let's go to the derivation.
Here we consider mirror M1, M2 and the wall is take as AB. Here two incident ray come from the two end of the wall. Okay, the two incident ray, one is AM1, BM2, falls on the surface of the mirror and reflection occur. Here M1E is the one reflected ray and M2E is the another reflected ray. The two reflected ray meet, converge or meet at point E. Here person is placed. The person is at the center of wall and mirror. The person is at the center of wall and mirror. As the two reflected ray meet at point A, so the person can able to see the image of the wall which is behind the person. The person's face is towards the mirror. The image of the wall is created or is formed behind the mirror. That one is the visual image is formed here. Visual image is formed. That image of the wall is formed behind the mirror. So that the person can able to see the image of the wall which is behind the person. So what is the height of the mirror so that the person can see the full image? Take us that height of the mirror M1, M2. Height of the mirror M1, M2. And height of the wall, that is AB. So here what happened? At point of incident M1, we know that angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. So if I is equal to R, this length is equal to this length. AC is equal to CD. AC is equal to CD. Next, at the second point of incident M2, here also angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. So BD is also equal to CD. BD is equal to CD. So what happened here? AC is equal to CD. CD is equal to BD. So AB is the height of the wall. Height of the wall equals to AB. That AB equals to AC plus CD plus BD. Okay. So as AC equals to CD equals to BD, that is written as 3 times of CD. Okay. So in geometrically, that CD is equal to M1, M2. CD is equal to M1, M2 because the two normal is parallel to each other. So CD is equal to M1, M2. As CD is equal to M1, M2. So AB is equal to 3 times of M1, M2. What is M1, M2? Height of the mirror. So, height of the mirror is equal to, that is M1, M2 is equal to 1/3 of the height of the wall. As that mirror height is 1/3 of the height of the wall, then a person in between wall and mirror can able to see the full image of the wall behind him.
M1, B, M2 are the two incident ray falls on the surface of the mirror where reflection occur. That M1E, M2E are the two reflected ray. The two reflected ray meet at the point E where the person stand. And the person is in between wall and mirror. Okay, now what happened here? M1E, M2 is one triangle. A prime, E, B prime is another triangle. Now we take that two triangle is equivalent to each other. Now we take the triangle M1E, M2 and triangle A prime, E, B prime. Here what happened? M1, M2 by A prime, B prime. A prime, B prime is equal to E cube by E Q prime. So here E Q, that is equal to X. Put the value and EQ prime, EQ that is X, Q prime that is 2X, that is the image distance. So total EQ prime that is 3X. So here XX cancel. Then M1, M2 is equal to 1/3 of AB. That means M1, M2 that is the height of the mirror. Height of the mirror is equal to 1/3 of height of the wall. The last topic of this video, the topic: if a plane mirror is rotated by an angle theta, reflected ray will be rotated by 2 theta. So let's derive that.
If we take the plane mirror at this position, okay, then what happened? Take an incident ray which falls the surface of the plane mirror. After reflection, it goes along OR. This one is the first reflected ray. When the mirror is at first position, here angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. At the point of incident, we draw normal, that ON1, that is the normal. So ION1 is equal to N1 OR1, that is equal to I, because angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. We know that angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection. So ION1 is equal to N1 OR1, that is equal to angle I. As we rotate the plane mirror at an angle theta, this one is the first position of the plane mirror. If we rotate it at an angle theta, this one is the new position of this plane mirror. And that incident ray is same position, comes from the same position. So now, what happened? This one is the incident ray, first that plane mirror, and reflection occur here. OR2 is the second reflected ray, new reflected ray, that is OR2. Okay, then in this condition, what happened here? And the new position, if we draw normal at the point of incident, ON2 is the normal. ON2 is the normal. So as we rotate the plane mirror at an angle theta, so that normal is also rotated by angle theta. Okay, and in the second condition, ION2 is equal to N2OR2. ION2 is equal to N2OR2, that is equal to angle I plus theta, because ION2, that is I plus theta. So ION2 and N2OR2, that is equal, that is angle I plus theta. We can determine what is this angle, that is R1OR2, that is equal to 2 theta. We determine this one. Okay, so what is R1OR2? So what is R1OR2? That is N1OR2 minus N1OR1, because N1OR1 R2, this one, N1OR2 minus N1OR1. Okay, then we got R1OR2. Okay, so what happened here? N1OR2 minus N1OR1, then we got R1OR2. Now what is N1OR2? That N1OR2 N1ON2 plus N2OR2. Okay, here we take N1ON2 plus N2OR2 minus N1OR1. Next, here what happened? N1ON2, take us N1ON2, that is theta, plus N2OR2, N2OR2, that N2OR2 equals to ION2, that is I plus theta, put the value I plus theta, minus N1OR1, take us N1OR1, N1OR1 equals to ION1, that is angle I, so put the value angle I, your angle I cancel, so that R1OR2, that is equals to 2 theta. If we rotate the plane mirror at an angle theta, by an angle 2 theta.